The Vice President Jessica Alupo, the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among, Chief Justice Alfonso Winidolo and several other ministers and members of parliament received the body of Jacob Olanya along family and friends. Members broke down as the casket was being lowered to the ground from the cargo chamber of the plane. At 3 p.m., the A-plus vehicle, accompanied by two airport traffic vehicles, slowly approached the site of the official handover ceremony. The Bishop of Northern Uganda Diocese led a short prayer, asking God to strengthen the family members and the nation as they go through this trying moment.
Thank you, Lord, for every effort that was put in place to save his life, but it was time for him to go. And now, as a family, as a church, and as a nation of Uganda, Father, we are heartbroken, and we are praying, Lord, that you will give us the grace to be able to bury our brother with dignity and with honor and to the glory of your name. May you strengthen everybody who is here. May you strengthen the members of the family and the Ugandan family at large, that, Lord, we will know that you reign even in this situation. May your glory be seen in all of these things. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. The Acholi cultural dance, Bola, was performed as is required by tradition to escort heroes and personalities of great importance.
The Right Honourable Speaker was accorded a royal welcome back home. So when you talk about the drumming, it doesn't make sense. It was the traditional dance. That's how we welcome prominent people. We welcome him home, we bury him with royalty. As a prominent son of the soil.
Olanya, aged 57, died at the University of Washington Medical Center, Seattle, USA, where he had been receiving treatment since the beginning of February.
We indeed receive the body with utmost sadness and grief, and government is going to accord the late Right Honorable Jacob Olanya a state funeral. The Right Honorable Jacob Olanya was a national leader, and therefore his life and work has a national bearing. I would like, therefore, to call upon all the people of Uganda to remain united.
Jacob Olanya had served as Speaker of Parliament for only 9 months, but because of poor health, he chaired very few sessions. This report was compiled by Mary Karugaba for the news.